Mr. James Blake is on the phone, and it's been a minute. How are you, James?
Zane, how you doing? Yeah, really good.
It's really nice to talk with you. It's even nicer, and I know you'll take this the right way, to hear your new song. What an amazing return. What a wonderful, sort of essential-sounding, beautiful piece of music you've made.
Oh, thank you so much. It's nice to hear that after quite a long time of just, well, making it.
You know, you can hear the crazy in it. No,
I'm yeah.
You know, that's just like everything. Exactly. But you know, it once we're about to set it free, and it will absolutely you know, evaporate in the best way out there. It's going to comfort people, man. It's going to wrap them up, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get into it right now. Come back and we'll get the information that you're looking for, and me from James Blake. But right now, the hottest record in the world. And thanks for letting us play this first, James. This is absolutely fantastic. Retrograde on Radio 1.
Exclusive and
Exclusive. This is Thursday night. Y'all better get ready. Ooh. And it's about 7:30 p.m. And my man Zane is about to put on the hottest
We missed it, man. It's all I can say is that, you know, A, no one has been able to make music that sounds like you or even attempted it. And I always think that that's a small but privileged list of musicians that have their own voice. And B, we really missed the kind of music that you make. Well, tell us what you can about Retrograde. Fill in the gaps that we've been missing during the making of that one song.
A lot's happened since I made my first record. I've kind of gone on tour and played to a lot of people and had the chance to meet a lot of people and kind of experiencing things I'd never experienced before that record, which could be some of the things I'm talking about in some of these songs. You never know.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like I've lyrically and musically find some way of better expressing myself in some way.
Yeah, and I think, and you correct me if I'm wrong, but there seemed to be, from our point of view, and this is only from personal experience, there was a bit of a turning point when, you know, you did the Joni Mitchell cover. And it just, I think a lot of people were really taken aback at, A, the ability that you had to be able to reinterpret a song that is you know, tricky and requires, you know, it's not meat and potatoes that. But also do it in your own way. And I don't know whether or not it's a coincidence in terms of timing or whatever, but that just felt to me like you had kind of been able to make some snips, you know, from what you were maybe perhaps tied to.
I did completely reimagine on this album. It does sound different, and it's, I think people who followed me from the start will probably be used to the kind of change arounds that happen, the next, you know, through the phases of my writing, and hopefully they'll just go with me again, because they've been so amazing so far. And so have you guys, and that Case of You cover just happened to be on your show, so it was a bit of a turning moment. It was a moment where I kind of just went, look, I'm just gonna sit down and play piano and sing, and that really, and it worked out for me. It was a kind of risk that paid off.
What a great realization to have been able to be so freewheeling in the studio and make things sound so interesting, and yet still, and make the connection before you actually was able to say to people, well, I can also do this. Because normally it's the other way around. Normally it's like, I'm going to go up on the school hall and I'm going to do some reinterpretations of Joni Mitchell, and then I might learn how to program. You came totally from the other way.
Yeah, it was a weird way to come about it. It's like I've always said I've kind of hit the road kind of from the opposite direction, really. Yeah. With, you know, because I did start, everything's really started from the piano and vocals. Maybe I've just learned. I mean, I'm learning a lot.
James, welcome back, man. It's really nice to talk with you. I look forward to doing that more. I can't wait to hear more of the record. April 8th for Overgrown, Retrograde, hottest record again. And, you know, well done, man. I know you always put a lot of like heart and soul into your music, and we can tell.
Thank you so much.
No, thank you, man. Seriously, those are the records that we live for, and we want to play it again.